mind that he is the king of the Jews? Have you made up your mind that he's the only one? I tell you, Mary and Joseph was there, and there's more to this story. But I tell you, we look around and see what Herod is doing to the world today, and what the different things are going on. It seems like the whole world is in turmoil, and they're not turning to the Lord Jesus Christ. But I want everybody to know that a born-again Christian that knows Jesus Christ as their personal Savior, they know what the outcome is going to be. It's going to be peace and joy and happiness on the streets of gold and the walls of jasper. But I said to somebody I want to know, I said, listen, it's not the streets of gold and the walls of jasper and the gates of pearl that I want to see. I want to see that man that died for me on Calvary and how he gave his life that we may have life and have it more abundantly. We look around and see a lot of different things in the world today, and a lot of people holler, Lord, Lord, and they're not of the Lord. And you be with them a little while and you'll know who they're serving. But I like to be around a group of people that serve the Almighty God, the one that can help us, the one that went in that tomb. He's there. He gave his life for you and for me. And I tell you, after 3 days, the devil still thought he had him. But after 3 days, the devil talked to death. He said, have you still got him? He said, I still got him. That was one day. The second day, he said, have you still got him? I still got him. But on the third day, have you still got him? He said, something happened this morning early. There's a power that comes from up above. And this power that comes from up above, he come out of that tomb victorious. He's alive. He's walking around in Jerusalem. He's alive in my heart today. His name is Jesus. Do you know him? Have you made up your mind that you're going to serve him? The devil's on one side, like I said, and the Lord's on the other side. It's your choice of what you're going to do. I serve the mighty God that's in me today. I thank God for Jesus Christ. My choice is Jesus Christ. I'm going to live for him. I'm going to do what he tells me to do. One day, I won't have to worry. Blessed and holy is he that has part in the first resurrection. Brother Jerry, I want to rise to meet the Lord in the air. I don't want to be left behind. But thank God for that baby Jesus that the man wanted to see. But thank God, I want to see him. But I want to see him for a different reason. I want to see him for what he done for me on Calvary. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Hi, Lord, I feel good. The devil is out to kill, steal, and destroy. Yeah. And I want to tell you something about him. I've been around long enough to know he's not going to do you any good. Mm-hmm. He'll make things look good for you. He'll make things look like they're bright and shiny. It's okay to do this, okay to do that. But you listen to what the Spirit of the Lord tells you to do. And if you're born again, you know Jesus Christ is your personal Savior. The Spirit of God come from God himself through Jesus Christ. It'll come down and tell you, don't do that.